for welcoming me into your classes and experience during my senior year. On my first day of school at Hopkins, my day ended with the Growth of 2 class, where I first met Ryan Phillips. From day one, Ryan made me feel welcome at Hopkins and made my days that much better in full of class. From being the only ones who found humor in Woodland Heights to doing a Shakespeare project together, Ryan always knew how to make not only me, but an entire class laugh. In addition to his humor, his intelligence and perseverance continues to amaze me, and I have no doubt that he will do great things in the future. UChicago is very lucky to have him. While I am deeply honored to be recognized as a valedictorian after this school year, I feel as though Ryan is best suited to the rest of the class. So without further ado, it is my honor to introduce Ryan Phillips.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let me begin by thanking all of you for attending the graduation of Hopkins Academy's class of 2018. This ceremony would not have been complete without our families. Families who have nurtured us in ways for which we will be forever grateful. This ceremony also would not have been complete without the sports coaches who have helped instill in us important values. Our principal, Mr. Beck, whose steady, consistent leadership has kept Hopkins Academy a safe and successful learning environment. And finally, the teachers who have educated us until this point and who are most directly responsible for the acquired knowledge and skills which will be integral to future academic success. Now, I think my classmates and I would agree with me in my profound gratitude for my Hopkins Academy education. More than simply providing a rigorous workload unknown to most other public high schools, the teachers of Hopkins Academy have provided passion. Passion which I believe is necessary in forging such a passionate class, aware of its talents and eager to apply them. Recently, I watched a class day speech by a member of Harvard University's class of 2018. One particular point in this oration stuck with me. We cannot claim our talents as, one, they are arbitrary forces dispensed to humans based on no moral standard, and two, they are developed thanks to the environment around us. Therefore, one must think of their talents as part of a common asset. And so the question, what am I going to do with my talents, becomes, what am I going to do with my talents for others? Indeed, our extraordinary capacities, no matter where they might lie, are mere blessings. Hopkins Academy has proven an exceptional environment in which these capacities have been developed, and this brings us to the future. How is Hopkins Academy's class of 2018 going to pay its education forward, using its capacities to help others? The problems facing our generation are some of the greatest the world has had to face. However, I have found two qualities in the students of this class which promise not only individual success, but inspiration to younger generations: ambition and skepticism. I have one piece of advice for myself and my ambitious, skeptical classmates, because I recognize in us the capacity to take this advice. Rather than being passive, idle, and blindly content, we should seek the truth and act accordingly. In a world in which so many people do not know their own thoughts and opinions, we should. Given that we all follow this advice, I hope and I believe that this class will go on to become model citizens, contributors to the fight against the problems which already surround us, either directly or indirectly. The time has finally come for the class of 2018 to go beyond the confines of Hadley and make a positive impact on the human condition. Thank you.
Good evening. 4 years ago, my brother graduated from Hopkins Academy, and this morning, I became aware of an interesting coincidence. When Zach graduated, he also fulfilled his particular responsibility. And so, in keeping up what is clearly a new Anderson family tradition, I would like to present Hopkins Academy Principal Brian Webb.
Thank you, Ben, Ryan, Sydney. Tonight, the class of 2018 becomes the 354th class to graduate from Hopkins Academy. Hopkins Academy has a long tradition of academic excellence. The class of 2018 will add remarkable talents to the 3.5 centuries of alumni who have come through its walls. This group of students is filled with exceptional artists and has outstanding, talented musicians, as we all enjoyed a sample of last evening, and whom we have all seen perform in the Hopkins chorus, Baz band, jazz band, and pep band through the years. The class of 2018 has outstanding athletes, a couple thousand point scorers in basketball, scholarship athletes, and many who have contributed to both boys and girls programs that have placed league and district title banners on the walls of this gymnasium. Before I make some final remarks about the class of 2018, I would like to extend personal and professional gratitude to so many people who have worked behind the scenes to support all the students here at Hopkins, as well as contributed to the events of the senior celebrations and the efforts of those who coordinate the presentation of awards and preparations for this graduation ceremony. First, I'd like to thank the class advisors, Lindsay Roberts and Terry Earle. Your professional guidance and consultations have helped to set an excellent example and an exceptional tone for end-of-year events going forward for years to come. Thank you. As we heard from many students last night, we are all thankful for the support, comfort, and wisdom of guidance counselor Angela Cullen. For their work in transforming our school facility around day after day over the last 2 weeks, special thanks to Mary Tanner, Stanley Magella, and most of all, Jeffrey Mish, whose tireless efforts to turn cafeterias and gymnasiums into auditoriums and arenas in record time does not go unnoticed. I'd also like to thank Wednesday's Nursery for the generosity of taking the time to turn our gymnasium into the Golden Rock Gardens. I would like to thank DRACs as well as the members of the Board of Trustees for their endless assistance in coordinating scholarships and awards, and for their time in helping us to coordinate for this night. I cannot say enough about the efforts of Nancy Fogarty and Jennifer Mendelson, our two administrative assistants. We are all deeply indebted to you for your excellence and dedication in coordinating each and every aspect of graduation, class night, and senior events. But this year was different because you did so in the midst of a crisis situation and handled that circumstance with incredible patience, tact, and dignity that sets an example for others. Nancy and Jennifer, we cannot thank you enough. Our students' support of appreciation, our students are all dependent on the support of the parents, families, and members of the community who serve in our music and athletic booster clubs, as well as helping hearts for Hadley Schools, the Hadley PTO, and the Hadley Mothers Club. We encourage all of you to consider joining each or any of these organizations and joining these dedicated people as their efforts bring such strong and direct benefit to our student learning and extend opportunities beyond the classroom walls for students to grow and learn. In addition, I would like to thank many of the local businesses who have shared so much in supporting our students: Esalon Cafe, Big Y, Maple Line Farm, Barstow's, the North Hadley Sugar Shop. And thank you all very much for the support of our students throughout the school year. But I would like to issue a very special thank you to the Flavors of Hope Farm. Last week, we had a wonderful day with the seniors from Smith Academy at our annual senior competition.
It was wonderful to see our students gleefully, almost confidently serving the greatest ice cream on the planet to students from their rival school. And to have the Smith seniors come back and approach me afterwards to ask, where did this come from? And to explain to them that it's just a little bit down the road. I wanted to take a moment to warn the Cook family, do not be surprised if the town of Hadley suddenly descends on your dairy. Thank you very much to the flavors of the farm. Thanks also to Catholic Media for sending the awards program and graduation live to all of Hadley. And thank you very much again to Tom Pitta for making sure that we will all have pictures of each of our graduates. We'd like to thank the school committee for their commitment to serve the students of Hadley Public Schools and to Dr. Annie McKenzie for her enthusiasm, her intellect, and her sense of humor. As many of you students acknowledged in the comments last night and this evening, I would also like to add a special thanks to the dedicated and exceptionally talented members of the Hopkins Academy faculty and staff who are so proud to have the pleasure of working with your students for the last 6 years. Thank you. Over the last couple of days, I prepared some remarks for the class of 2018, and I found out this morning, as I reviewed Brian Phillips' speech, that he and I had clearly seen the same speech. So I was forced to make changes to mine. And I'm pleased to highlight another characteristic of the class of 2018 that I hope serves as a model for generations and graduating classes to come. Back in November, my father, Jack Beck, lost his battle with ALS. We got together as a family and celebrated his life with what he only knew, which was laughter, constant humor. It was his only emotion. We never heard him make fun of anyone. We never heard him put anybody down. His affability and general affection for any other human being could be felt anytime we were in his presence. But there was something else that always gave me a sense of pride in who he was as a person. It was his exceptional work ethic. He was the field and office vice president of Metro Sprinkler Systems in Peabody for 25 years, and he was charged with supervising every employee and every contract that this multi-million dollar company had. His a memorial was posted online, and several weeks later, I got this strange and random confirmation of what I always felt was most impressive about him, and what I see in many of you. From a complete stranger in the online guestbook. It read as follows. I've worked with Jack for several years. During that time, I never heard him raise his voice at any of us or call anyone out, and I, for one, gave him many reasons to do so. He simply showed up earlier and left the job later than everyone else, each and every day. He was always the best at whatever he did, and he always was willing to help each of us improve our skills with patience and kindness. We all learned by his example that the job always got done right and always got done the right way. But this year, the class of 2013 made me think of that snippet online. In the 20 years that I have been an educator, I have never seen a graduating class not have a case of senioritis. While many classes who precede you begin to slack off as they've made their commitments to college, trades, career paths, the class of 2013 worked hard right up to the last day of classes. You can see the stress, the tension, in some cases the pride in their faces. This is the last paper and it's coming out right. I don't know how many of us could say that as we tried to pass it in as quickly as we possibly could. Maybe even getting it from somebody else. These students worked incredibly hard, right up to the end. While Ryan alluded to the inherent talents that you all have and the responsibility to others, he hopes that you will keep this in mind as you move forward and make a commitment to help others with those talents. It's my hope that you make a commitment and dedication to an unwavering work ethic, because this is what will set you apart from your peers as you leave Hopkins Academy. and bring each of you greater opportunities. Thank you all for ending your senior year by setting such a great example for all of our students. The list of scholarships and awards that I have the privilege to announce today is testimony to the outstanding efforts of the senior class and the support shown to students, of Hopkins Academy by the local community. In the days to come, these young men and women will share their personal gratitude and support for the awards extended to them by the Hopkins Academy Board of Trustees, the Hadley Mothers Club, the Hadley PTO, Helping Hearts for Hadley Schools, the Hopkins Academy Athletic Boosters, and the Hopkins Academy Music Boosters Club. With your endless efforts on behalf of our students, Hopkins Academy is able to provide an incredible educational experience for our students, and then ultimately to send so many of them forward with badly needed financial assistance for their educational pursuits after high school. And now we've reached the time when we will recognize the accomplishments of the class of 2018. With your programs tonight, you have been given a list of all of the scholarships and awards that will be presented. As each award is announced, you will be able to read the description of the scholarship or award that's provided in the criteria. Please do not jump in the aisles or approach the stage for pictures. Mr. Pitta will ensure that everybody has pictures of their children, their students, and then a copy of the diplomas and award pictures will be available to each graduate and their families. So please refrain from rushing the stage to take pictures during the awards or diploma presentation. Tonight's first award, the James P. Reed Athletic Medal, goes to senior Jonathan Morrison. The James Robert Ryan Prize goes to Alexander Kaczynski and Margaret Mahal. The Emerson Prize is awarded to Ryan Phillips. The Mary McGrath O'Brien Debating Prize goes to Joseph Sykowski. The Bridget A. Ryan Prize, in memory of Minnie R. Dwight, is awarded to Isabel Flynn. The other Bridget A. Ryan Prize goes to Miranda Pitta. The Old Hadley Lions Club Agricultural Scholarship goes to Benjamin Anderson. The Henry E. Ryan Arthur Ryan Award goes to Jonathan Morrison. The Hope Grange Youth Mathematics Prize is awarded to Ryan Phillips. The American Legion Scholarship goes to Margaret Mahalik. The Constance Higgins Alumni Prize is awarded to Miranda Pitta. The Florence M. Reed English Prize goes to Sydney Scott. The Fannie G. Allen Award goes to Ryan Phillips. The Faculty Award goes to Benjamin Anderson. The Mary E. Kennedy Award goes to Jack Turdos. The Hadley Young Men's Club Stanley Vannis Memorial Education Aid Award goes to two students, Juliet Cook and Michael Carter. The Dwight History Prize goes to Jack Turdos. The Hadley Education Association Scholarship is awarded to Joseph Sykowski. The John Philip Sousa Band Award goes to Benjamin Anderson. The Louis Armstrong Award goes to Miranda Pitt. The Bud Neyland Award goes to Michael Carter. The Paul W. Brown Senior Baseball Award goes to Nathan Kelly. The Major Henry B. Selagi Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Miranda Pitt. The George C. Hibbert Alumni Scholarship goes to Isabel Flynn. The Hadley Mothers Club prizes this year are awarded to Alexander Kaczynski, Hannah Bradar, and Isabel Flynn. The Burton P. Shores Memorial Prize this year is awarded to Muhammad Adam Yaman. The Daniel M. Zagranik Memorial Math Prize this year goes to Hannah Bradar. The Joseph and Mary Nancy Prize goes to Jonathan Morrison. The National School Choral Award goes to Sydney Scott. You work for from having people interested in the arts goes to Mahin Ahmed. The Nellie A. and John W. Sigowski Memorial Award goes to Cassandra Dwight. The Barbara G. and John S. Byron Scholarship Fund this year goes to Miranda Pitt. The Nancy E. Malinowski Urgiel Memorial Scholarship goes to Isabel Flynn. The Paul M. Lamassi Soccer Award goes to Michael Tarn. The John Mish Senior Memorial Scholarship goes to Isabel Flynn. The May and Oscar Johnson Scholarship goes to Sydney Scott. The Richard A. Graves Memorial Scholarship this year goes to Muhammad Adoyami. The Leon G. Jasinski Memorial Scholarship this year is awarded to John J. Earl. The Frank E. Kolaski Memorial Scholarship this year is presented to Miranda Pitt. The Joseph Michael Kanasny Jr. Award this year goes to Nathan Kelly. The Joseph and Mary E. Zaterka Memorial goes to Juliet Cook. The Margaret L. Kelly Memorial Scholarship this year is awarded to Joseph Sikowski. The Lisa Marie Wiskiewicz Memorial Scholarship, Memorial Award, I'm sorry, goes to Fletcher Bullock. The Northampton Lodge of Elks number 997 scholarship this year is awarded to Hannah Berard. The Sheriff Robert J. Garvey Scholarship Award goes to Ryan Phillips. The Adolph and Mary Paczynski Scholarship this year goes to Jack Turdos. The Peg Dion Memorial Scholarship is presented to Hannah Berard and Nathan Kelly. The Florence Bank Scholarship is presented to Juliet Cook. Thank you. to Isabel Flynn. The Golden Hawk Award in memory of Jerry Train Jr. this year is presented to Michael Carmen. The Eleanor Van Dorn Smith Memorial Scholarship is presented to Mahim Ahmed. The Stanley and Stacia Cozera Memorial Scholarship this year is presented to Isabel Flynn. The class of 2018 recipient of the Rotary Scholarship is Chloe Bollier. The Independent Order of the Odd Fellows Scholarship is presented to Benjamin Anderson. The Teddy S. Soldea Memorial Scholarship is presented to Nathan Kelly. The Peter Allen Jagunowski Memorial Scholarship is presented to Margaret Mahalik. The Michael R. Ribbeck Jr. Memorial Scholarship is presented to three students, Nathan Kelly, Benjamin Anderson, and Cassandra Dwight. The Barbara Kinesi Memorial Scholarship goes to Margaret Mahalik. The John S. Sinkowitz Memorial Scholarship also presented to Margaret Mahalik. The Christopher M. DeLisle Scholarship goes to Benjamin Anderson. The Woody Herman Jazz Ensemble Award also goes to Ben Anderson. The Tom Hannigan Scholarship is presented to Juliette Cook. The Hampshire County College Fair Association Award this year goes to Diani Ali. The Chet Bai Junior Athletic Soccer Award is presented to Benjamin Anderson. The Chet Bai Junior Athletic Baseball Award goes to Justin Butterfield. The Hopkins Academy Trustee Scholarship in memory of Norman Simbarsko Sr. goes to Ewan O'Brien. The Hopkins Academy Sports Booster Club Athletic Awards are presented to Juliet Cook and John J. Earl.
The Quincy Jones Scholarship Award is presented to Ryan Phillips. The Sandra Walsh Kelly Memorial Scholarship is presented to Alicia Sneed. The Tom Cassenzi Memorial Scholarship this year is awarded to Benjamin Anderson. The Deborah J. Crozier Memorial Award is presented to Ryan Phillips. The Constance Ann Najelski Memorial Scholarship is presented to Eric Belton. Marion Purdy Memorial Scholarship this year is awarded to Isabel Flynn. And the Coach's Award is given to Hannah Berard. The John J. Paczynski Memorial Scholarship this year is presented to Justin Siago. The Sam Koch Award this year is presented to Margaret Mahalik and Benjamin Anderson. The Michelle Searle Scholarship is presented to Joseph Sykowski. The Noreen Jacobus Tiley Award goes to Miranda Pitta. The Mary Lou C. Masala Scholarship this year is presented to Cassandra Dwight. Congratulations to each of the scholarship and award recipients of the class of 2018.
Up until about 125 years ago. but we have remained involved ever since then. And it is our pleasure each year to award graduations and scholarship, graduation scholarships, as well as approximately $25,000 in other support for the school as a whole. The scholarship process involves an application filled out by the students with an essay, recommendations from teachers or community members, and an interview with the subcommittee of the Board of Trustees. This year, we were really impressed with the quality of the applications, the composure of the applicants, and I think we have broken our record for scholarship awards. Without further ado, at the level of a $500 scholarship for 1 year, Jordan Lashley. Also at the level of $500 for 1 year, Liv Hart.
Move up to the $2,000 level.
500 a year for 4 years. Alexander Kucinski. And next, at the $2,000 level, Isabel Flynn. Now, we went a little above and beyond our usual award levels this year. At the $3,000 level, an award of $750 a year for 4 years, Miranda Pitta. Again, going beyond our usual norms, an award of $4,000 scholarship, $1,000 a year for 4 years, to Ryan Phillips. So by my quick math, we have awarded a total of $26,500 tonight.
Good evening. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming tonight. We started our 7th grade year, shut up about Hopkins. After being the big kids at the elementary school, we're now the big kids at Hopkins. What we didn't know is there was also a new teacher here at Hopkins. Ms. Roberts was in the same boat as us. We had something in common. This is one of the many reasons why we connect so well with Ms. Roberts. Without further ado, it's Ms. Roberts.
Good evening, everybody. I'm excited to be here tonight for class 2018. I also have the privilege of teaching mostly students for the past 6 years, as well as being their advisor for the past 4 years. My connection with them goes obviously much deeper than that. As their teacher, advisor, coach, confidant, phone charging station, Chromebook sheet holder, paintball target, our connection is so much more, and the memories we've shared and experiences will something that will last with me forever. Although those memories are priceless, their importance to me is just very deep, as their first year, as Nature said, was my first year, not just here, but in the teaching profession. So they are the first graduating class that I follow throughout my time at Hopkins, and that's something that I will remember forever. Throughout those 6 years, they have made a lasting impression on the Hopkins community. During that time, many words come to mind to describe them. A few are passionate, fierce, stubborn, persistent, headstrong, determined, and revolutionary. To me, those qualities are exactly what I want for my students as they go off into the world. Be the strong individuals that you are. Don't back down from a challenge. Continue to question the status quo. Always push leaders to stay on their toes and challenge them to do better. Push for the right thing, even when people are telling you it's the wrong thing. Always be the intense and amazing individuals that I know and that I adore. Because those people are the people who will make society better. Now, I'm not saying that you shouldn't evolve and grow, but always remember the qualities that you have. People with these qualities are the ones that make a difference and the ones that change the world. It has been an honor and privilege to have been a part of your lives for the past 6 years, and I look forward to seeing what you do in the next phase of your lives. I am humbled to stand up here in front of all of you after a long 6 years together and to be one of the first to say good luck and congratulations, class of 2018. Thank you.
Pratt, Ms. Collin, school committee members Tara Bruger and Tamara Fossey-Katine, and Superintendent Dr. Amy McKenzie Forward for the presentation of diplomas.
Sydney Lillian Scott. Alexander Yurji Kaczynski. Jordan Lashway. John Joseph Earl Jr. Miranda Sykes Pitt. Benjamin Jacob Anderson. Isabel Beatrice Flynn. Ewan Robert James O'Brien. Juliet Ann Cook. Michael Gordon Carter. Hannah Mary Josephine Barrar. Ryan Alexander Phillips. Leah Hannah Picard. Nathan Paul Kelly. Cassandra Graves Dwight. Jack Thomas Tirdos. Chloe Nicole Monier. Justin Matthew Butterfield. Margaret Mary Mahalik. Justin Joseph Slaver. Alicia Naomi Stevens. Jonathan Francis Morrison. Muhammad Adam Yaman. Erica Leona Phillips. Eric Belton. Tayana Marie Parks. Joseph John Zykowski. Marie Giselle Soto Guzman. Fletcher Noble Bullock. Diane Ali. Vance Rock Canella. Maheen Ahmed.
On behalf of the Hopkins Academy Class of 2018, I have the honor of presenting the Distinguished Alumni Award tonight. This recipient grew up in Hadley and raised three boys here with his wife Hadley. After graduating from Hopkins in 1983, he attended Springfield College where he received a bachelor's degree in Human Service Administration and later a degree in Education from Jackson. He has been a teacher at Hadley Elementary School for 23 years and has taught most of my class both math and science. When he is not teaching Hadley students, he spent countless hours working at CYO and AAU basketball and powerlifting baseball organizations. He has coached and mentored many of the student athletes sitting here on the stage and in the audience tonight. His years of time, effort, motivation, and encouragement have helped contribute to many banners hanging in the gymnasium. His love for and commitment to my classmates in the Hopkins community is undeniable. After 29 years of coaching, he decided to follow his dreams of owning a baseball franchise, only to return halfway through the girls' varsity basketball season when the team needed a coach. His commitment doesn't stop there. He takes great pride in how our peers and schools look. Oftentimes, he's seen helping work on our fields, building the pitchers' mounds, and edging the baseline to make them look their best. I would like to personally say thank you to him Enzo Busas for buying catchy gear this season to catch me from John Morris and 90 Mile an Hour Basketball. I can't thank him enough for what he has done for us throughout our years in Hadley school system, and what we will know he will continue to do for all the students to come. I couldn't imagine a more deserving Hopkins Academy Distinguished Alumni recipient. I am honored and privileged to represent the Distinguished Alumni Award to my uncle, Fred Jagger.
Good evening, Hopkins Academy Board of Trustees, school committee members, Superintendent McKenzie, Principal Beck, colleagues, families, friends, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2018. I'm truly honored to receive this award. Hadley is a special place. I grew up here, and I attended the Hadley schools. I chose to raise my family here, and I've been teaching and coaching in Hadley for almost 25 years, and I've enjoyed every minute of it. I hope all of you have enjoyed your years at Hopkins, and you can look back at them as some of the best years of your life. Now you are all moving on to a new adventure. Some of you will move away from Hadley and settle down somewhere else, and some of you may return. Either way, I hope that Hadley and Hopkins Academy will always hold a special place in your hearts as it does in mine. I will leave you with a little saying that I found. I think it's appropriate, especially after watching my wife for the last month. Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. Thank you again for honoring me with this Distinguished Alumni Award. Congratulations to the class of 2018. I wish you all the best.
In recent years, graduating classes have chosen an exemplary person who made an impact on their class to honor as an alumni of Hopkins Academy. This year, we chose to honor someone who taught at Hopkins Academy for over 25 years. She was a teacher and mentor to all of us, as her last 8th grade history class was the class of 2018. Now she spends her time contributing to the community, as she is a member of the First Congregational Church and often raises money for local charities, substitute the Hopkins Academy when needed, and own the local farm. For these reasons, we as a class wanted to honor Mrs. Sharon Carson as an honorary alumni of Hopkins Academy. I just want to say thank you. Hopkins will always be in my heart. I remember my first year here, Mrs. Diablo was boys basketball coach, and I was the girls cheerleading coach in any evening. But most importantly, I don't have a long speech prepared because these kids learned enough from me when they were in the grade. But I'm truly honored you will be my last kids, and in my heart, forever.
And now, it is my great honor and privilege to present to you the Hopkins Academy Class of 2018.
This time passed, the spectacle faded, and we got me started with Windows. That was until the principal left for the school changed. It took some time, but eventually we adapted to our neighborhood and got used to everything. Until then, until the next principal left, we got to do it all over again. Three principals, new teachers every other year, and a bunch of schedule changes led to our Hopkins experience being as chaotic as it gets. But I'm not telling you all this so you can feel bad for it. I'm telling you so you can see just how amazing a group of young adults behind you is. Through all the changes over the years, this class never faltered. Sure, none of us particularly enjoyed memorizing new schedule every year, but I never stopped class in person. In my opinion, all the changes that we've experienced help shape us as the people we are today. And we all sure have come a long way, taking it first. At the elementary school, I would spend so much time in the principal's office that I had my own desk. But now, I like to think that I've become far more mature and responsible as a result of all the things I've faced. The majority of my classmates, myself included, are attached, as well as part of both the Diversity Club and the Gender Equity Task Force, which are three movements that I probably would have never thought of joining when I was younger. But after spending all this time with my class, I was encouraged to join them, and I'm glad that I did. Thanks to the experience I've shared with my classmates, I've changed for the better. If you'd have told the 12-year-old me that I was in the principal of this senior class, I probably would have just laughed and walked away. But here we are. Whether or not doing a good job is still a great day. Spending over a decade with this class has truly been a ride. But even though we sometimes bicker and argue, I'm sure I speak for the entirety of the class when I say that I will miss every single one of you and always cherish the time that we spend together. As we graduate, and most of us split apart to different colleges and different places around the world, I can't help but be thankful for all the amazing and kind things this class has done for me. I'd like to thank Jack for being the best vice president I could ask for, and for stopping me every time I make a bad decision, which was just about everything. I'd like to thank John J. and Adam for giving me Brian's 64 after almost every soccer practice. I'd like to thank Justin C. for somehow being both my best friend and my worst enemy in this school. I'd like to thank Joe for giving me all of these snacks all the time. And I'd like to thank Leah for always being there to give me advice whenever I had a hard decision. I could go on all day about all the great things that my classmates have done for me. But all of it pales in comparison to what I value the most. So I'd like to thank each and every one of you for giving me a chance to be something far more than just your class colleague, and for letting me represent you all as a class president. Thank you.
Thank you. closed, we ask you all to join us in the cafeteria for the reception. At the reception, we ask that you go along in the orderly manner and take a brief moment to hear graduates. We will now play our class song, Home Sweet Home by Motley Crue.